Hello students, in last video we have seen how criminals plan attack, phases involved in that, types of hackers. Okay, next we will see the social engineering. Social engineering is the technique to influence people to obtain the information. It means it is an art of manipulating a people's mind so they can give confidential information easily. Here, social engineers change mind of people to get the confidential information. It is generally observed that the people are the weak link in security, and this principle makes social engineering possible. It means the social engineers always look for people's security weakness, then he will attack on him. A social engineer usually uses a telecommunication like telephone or cell phone or internet to get them to do something that is against the security practices and or policies of the organization. Okay, it is against the security practices and against the policies of the organization. Social engineering is art of exploiting, means breaking the trust of the people. The goal is to fool someone into providing valuable or a sensitive information or to get access to that information. A simple example is calling a user and pretending, means acting to be someone from service desk or a tech support working on the network issue. The attacker then proceeds to ask questions about what a user is working on, what files he or she using, what is his or her password, and so on. Okay, we will see some simple conversation between a person or an employee and tech support guy. Okay, this is a small conversation. Okay, this includes two people, that is tech support guy, we can call him as a caller, and an employee, that is Mr. Joshi. Okay, Mr. Joshi, hello. The caller, hello Mr. Joshi, this is Geeta Thomas from tech support. Due to some disk space constraints on the file server, we will be moving few users' home directories to another disk. This activity will be performed tonight at 8 p.m. Your account will be part of this move and will be unavailable temporarily. Mr. Joshi, oh, okay, I will be at my home by then. Anyway, caller, great, please ensure to log off before you leave office. We just need to check a couple of things. What is your username? Mr. Joshi, username is P. Joshi. None of my files will be lost in move, right? Caller, no sir, but we will have to check your account to ensure the same. What is your password of that account, sir? Mr. Joshi, my password is ABCD1965. All characters are in uppercase. Caller, okay Mr. Joshi, thank you for your cooperation. We will ensure that all the files are there. Mr. Joshi, thank you, bye. Caller, bye and have a nice day. Okay, by making these kind of conversations, they will try to get your username and password in a social engineering. The next is classification of social engineering. The first one is human-based social engineering. Second one is computer-based social engineering. In human-based social engineering, it refers to person-to-person interaction to get the information. Okay, for example, calling from a tech support and trying to find out the passwords. Okay, previously we have seen, no, like that, the tech support guy will call from tech support and he will try to find out the passwords. How they will try by using? How they will try to find out these passwords? By using following methods. Okay, the first one is impersonating an employee or a valued user. Here, impersonation means posing or acting as an employee from a same organization. This technique is used by most of the social engineers to deceive or fool people. The next is posing as an important user. In this technique, attacker pretends to be as an important user. For example, CEO of an organization or a high-level manager who needs immediate assistance or a help to access a system. The attacker uses intermediation so that a lower level employee such as help desk will help them to access this information or gain access to a system. Here we used one word, that is intermediation, means they will make afraid of them. Okay, because of that they will easily leak the information about access rights and all to the system. The third one is using third person. Here an attacker pretends or act like he has a permission from an authorized source to use a system. Okay, here this trick is very useful when authorized person is on leave or he is outside the country, like that. Okay, at that time the attacker will use these kind of methods. The fourth technique or a method is calling a technical support. Usually the help desk and technical personnel are trained to help the users or employees. In this technique, social engineers or attackers pretends or acts as a technical support executive and tries to get the information from a user over a phone call. The fifth one is shoulder surfing. In this technique, they will gather the information such as username and password, watching over a person's shoulder while he or she logs into system. They may help attacker to gain access to the system by telling his or her username and password. The last one is dumpster diving. This is the sixth technique or a method we can call. It involves looking in a trash or a dustbin or a recycle bin for information written on pieces of paper or a computer printouts like passwords, file names or any useful information. It also includes searching through a object residue. For example, discarded tapes, discs or papers to acquire the sensitive data or important data without any authorization. Okay. Here are the some examples. Here, what cyber criminal is doing from a person who is on the right side. He is a cyber criminal and he is making a call to an employee, and what he is asking, could you please give your employee ID and password to reconcile your salary data? Okay, at that time the employee will automatically give his username and password because he is targeting his salary. Okay, like that they will change the mind of a person by using a single word called salary here. Okay, the next example is a cyber criminal. What he is doing? Hi Amy, this is Joy from IT. I am working from home today. Okay, by telling this, he will take the username and password of an employee. Okay, from a tech support guy. Okay, here tech support guy is Amy. These are the examples for shoulder surfing. Okay, in left side image, what she is doing? She is withdrawing money by entering a PIN. Okay, a person behind her is looking her ATM PIN. okay, on right side a girl or a lady, she is logging into system, and a person behind her is looking for her password and user ID. Okay, we can call this method as shoulder surfing. The next one is computer based social engineering. Computer based social engineering is an attempt made to get the acquired or a required information by using a computer software or a internet. For example, sending a fake email to the user and asking him or her to re-enter the password in a web page to confirm it. Okay? They have given some examples. Okay, in fake email, what attacker will do? He sends the fake emails to the large number of users, and users believe it as a legitimate or a valid mail. This activity is called as phishing. It is an attempt to attract the internet users to reveal their personal information such as username, password, credit card details. Okay? Bank and financial institutions and payment gateways are the common targets for a phishing. Phishing is carried out through the emails or a instant messaging or a it directs users to websites, and they will ask users to ensure the details at a website. Or a website is designed by an attacker in such a way that it will look like a original website itself. The next technique or a method is the attacker uses to commit a social engineering is by an email attachment. Okay, these are used to send malicious code to victim's system, which will automatically get executed. For example, viruses, trojans, worms are included in attachments. When user clicks on that email attachments, the code is executed automatically and viruses or worms are inserted in our system automatically. The next method is pop-up windows. Okay, by using these, the attackers can insert viruses or install malicious software in our system. How they will install? When pop-up window pops up, if we click on that pop-up window, it automatically inserts viruses, worms, or it may install a malicious softwares. Okay. These are some examples. Okay, see here, this is example for a fake email. Okay, they are using a Chase Bank. Okay, but the email ID is not in the name of Chase Bank. Okay, here to verify an account, they have given one link, but that link is not going to the link of Chase Bank. Okay, it is something different. Okay, the next okay, only these two they have given in fake emails. Okay, the link is not pointing to actual link of that bank, and that mail does not contain any bank name there. Okay, this is example for fake email. This is example for email attachment. Okay, this is a email from Bank of America, and here they have given some spelling mistakes. See, after A is capital and dear member, M should be capital there. Okay, and from, okay, enough from Bank of America they are giving, but email ID is not in the name of Bank of America. And to, they have not giving any email ID is there. Just they are telling undisclosed recipients. Okay, that should not be the case. And some spelling mistakes are there. And fonts, your account, that is very, the font size is very less here, okay, and that link is not https://www.bankofamerica.com, that is not linking to the link of Bank of America, okay. So it is linking to http bit.do or something else is there, some other link is there, okay. If we click on that attachment, it will automatically insert viruses, Trojan horses or some malicious softwares. Okay, this is example for email attachments. This is example for pop-up windows. Okay, while browsing, this kind of pop-up window will arise in our screen. Okay, what it is telling here? Reset altered Chrome settings. Okay, Chrome detected that your browser settings may have been changed without your knowledge. Would you like to reset them to their original defaults? Okay, but usually Chrome will not ask these kind of settings. Okay, if you click on reset, it will automatically install viruses or worms in your system. Okay, usually Chromes or any browsers will not ask for these kind of settings. This is example for pop-up windows. Thank you.